amazing entrance. Who have we got here?
Afrinita, and I'm here with Abigail.
Yes!
Amazing. And Afrinita, who have you brought with you today?
I'm here with Abigail's mom and my auntie and her daughter.
What have you come to do for us today?
Okay, so we are here to dance. Mm-hmm. Abigail over here is one amazing dancer from Ghana. She was actually born deaf. She got a hearing aid recently, It actually helps her to hear a bit, but only in her left ear.
Amazing.
Yes. The first time I saw her, I felt so strong, I decided to mentor her.
Oh my goodness.
Abigail has always been dancing, even when she was a little girl. Just move those left feet. I saw a video of her. I got goosebumps all over my body. And it became a dance duo after that. But I feel better when I'm dancing. It makes me happy. I make her happy. It's just beautiful. It's just beautiful.
Abigail doesn't understand sign language. We communicate through body movements and gestures.
She hears loud sound with vibrations, either from her feet or in her chest. Abigail loves to watch Britain's Got Talent. She has a tablet, and if you go on it, you see her YouTube history. Britain's Got Talent, Britain's Got Talent, Britain's Got Talent.
It's always been Abigail's dream to be on BGT,
so I just knew that I had to help her. Disability is not inability. Once you have a talent, you have a gift. The plan is to make Simon smile. We are bringing the Ghanaian energy here today. We are about to shut down the whole auditorium.
Amazing. Well, listen, I cannot wait to see this. Good luck.
Thank you.
insanely cool. So joyous, so brilliant, so much fun. Hands down, you are two of the most fantastic dancers we have ever had on Britain's Got Talent.
God, you two are dancing queens! Your choreography is, I'm telling you, is world class. You are not just great dancers, you are a great choreographer as well.
Both of you are just a breath of fresh air. That is just natural, God-given talent that you're born with. I loved it!
What you've done, being a mentor, is just the most wonderful story. It really, really is. When this goes out, I really believe your lives are going to change for the better. This is one of my favourite auditions of the year. Let's vote, Bruno.
Oh, yes, yes, yes!
I'm saying yes!
It's a yes from me.
Four yeses. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. Lovely to meet you. What's your name?
My name is Innocent Masugu.
Can I just say, you look amazing.
Thank you.
I love that top. Yeah. I love it.
So this was actually made by my mom. Yeah.
Aww. That's so cute.
It looks really nice on you.
We're moving to fashion.
Okay.
It's all right.
Great. Okay, well, look, tell me about you.
I'm Innocent Masugu from South Africa, but I live in London.
Okay, now, you think you're going to win?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, I think let's find out.
You ready?
Yes. Okay. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
E tira forte il vento.
That's special, isn't it?
Ma dal volto di sorriento. Un uomo in braccio una ragazza dopo che aveva pianto. Poi si schiarisce la voce e ricomincia il canto.
Good, eh?
Amazing!
I'm trying to hold my breath, let it stay this way. Can't
we love him! Love him!
Take my hand and share it with me. Starting without you.
Oh my God!
Words. I found that overwhelming,
yes.
Actually. Yep. By the end of that song, I felt like I was just hit in the chest with this force, like it felt divine almost.
Yeah.
This is your calling.
Oh, I couldn't agree more.
It was very, very special. You are special.
Every year, we've got to keep raising the bar. When we're looking for talent,
you
we
have
can't
to.
Look back. We have to have people who go beyond our expectations, and that's exactly what you did today. Hands down, in the 17 years that we've been doing Britain's Got Talent, you are by far the best opera singer we have ever had.
Oh, wow.
I think it was because your mum made your top.
Yes, yeah. Yes, it's the energy problem.
I'm really curious, have you had people who've said you're not very good?
The worst thing was you won't get really far with opera, so stop.
I hope this idiot is watching this right now.
Me too.
Because that was wonderful. I mean, seriously wonderful. So heartfelt and so powerful. You deserve this break. You really, really do. I have a feeling I know which way this is going. Bruno.
Yes.
Alicia.
It's a yes from me.
Amanda.
It's a yes from me.
What do you think? That's about 4,000 yeses.
Goodness.
You're amazing.
What a great audition. That was unbelievable.
It was. This year it's all about real people, it feels like.
Yeah, you're right.
That was incredible. That doesn't happen very often.
I almost like cried, you know. I held myself because, you know, I just contain myself. I can't be crying on television.
Away from South Africa, tell me, how does it feel to be on All Stars?
Yeah, we're so excited to be here. That we just wanted this chance and now we got it and we are back.
Hi, we are the Ndlovu Youth Choir. We are from South Africa in Limpopo. Before the audition, life was really hard. We were collecting water using wheelbarrows, you know, when we went to fetch water.
We started this choir to give young people on the African continent a voice they didn't have.
Some of us have been able to support our families and, you know, getting electricity. We now have running water.
Well, coming into this competition, we have a whole lot of weight on our shoulders, more so because we're representing Africa as a whole.
We got this opportunity that a lot of guys like us back home are wishing and hoping for.
I say the message we always try to transcend is that you can overcome your obstacles, your problems. It should never define you. It should never.
We were excited to be here on AGT All-Stars. We want to show the whole world that anything is possible.
Welcome back. Can you introduce yourselves again, please?
We are the Ndlovu Youth Choir, all the way from South Africa, Limpopo.
You did amazing on the show. We've used you as a reference for some of the best choirs we've ever had.
Thank you, thank you.
For me, this is my favorite choir that has ever been on AGT.
Thank you.
Thank you. You feeling confident?
Definitely, we're here to win this.
Yeah! Yes!
I would think it must be the hardest thing being in a choir is how do you choose the song?
So we've been brave and we've chosen an original song.
That's good.
And I think it shows the progression because we want to be creative and we want to create our own music.
And the song is about?
It's about the resilience of the human spirit. It says we will rise.
I like that.
Yeah!
Okay. Good luck.
With you guys, and I loved it. I love how vibrant you are inside and out. I loved it.
Traditionally, I don't respond to choirs. I've seen choirs, and I always kind of have the same comment. The same comment is, I feel like it's a school assembly, and it's nice for that. This didn't look like an assembly. This looked like a finished Broadway show. And I truly mean this. For me, this would have been a golden buzzer moment, really. Wow. It would have been.
Well, first of all, absolutely, you did the right thing. coming back with your own material. I thought it was just strong. I got it. I think Howie's reference as a Broadway show is absolutely on the money. And what an unbelievable reaction from the audience behind me.
Yes, yes.
Really? Because that you can't take.
Hopefully they get that same reaction from the superfans, because the superfans can only pick one act from the night.
I know, literally one. However, you did everything you possibly could, in my opinion, and I can't be more thrilled that you've come back to compete again. All of you, thank you.
You are fantastic!
All right, there you go, guys. What do you want to say to the super fans?
We just want to say to the super fans that we're just so happy to be here, and you have the opportunity to give us one more shot, and we'd really appreciate it.
Oh, how are you guys? Hi, Simon.
How are you doing?
We are good. We are so excited.
Yes! So, tell everybody where you're from and what brings you to Britain's Got Talent today.
Okay. We are from Uganda, Kampala, Africa. So we are going to dance for you guys and for you judges.
Yes!
Oh, thank you!
And have you brought anyone with you?
Mr. Kavma Dauda.
Is he there?
Yes.
Can he say hi? Can we say hi?
Yeah, go on, please do.
Hi! Oh, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much.
Tell us a little bit about this group.
I have 30 kids that I'm taking care of. Some are orphans. We are using music, dance and drama to make lives better.
Amazing. Oh my God, it's amazing.
Oh, bless you, darling. That's incredible.
Ghetto Kids is like an orphanage in Uganda. We are 30 kids living in one house.
We are one big family.
Before, I was living on the streets of Kampala. Being part of the Ghetto Kids has given me a lot of opportunities. They feed me, I go to school, they buy me clothes. If this one is sad, we all be sad. If we are happy, we all be happy. Over the hills and far away, take me to my happy place. Mr. Kavma Dauda, we call him Dad. He's not our real father, but he's the one who takes care of all of us.
Ghetto Kids is all about making their lives better through paying their school fees, feeding, hospital bills, all the basic needs that a child wants. My dream is to build a very big home and help many kids as I can. Over the hills and far away. It's a happy place because it's all about making lives better through dance.
Because of him, that's why we go to school. That's why we are healthy. Because of him, that's why we are here.
This is the first time for the kids to be in London, and they are so excited.
What do you think London's like?
London, it's cold. It's freezing.
I'll be so proud to watch all of them perform tonight.
Because of dance, we are here. We can't wait. We are so happy. We are so excited. Take me to my happy
place. Well, we're all rooting for you, and the stage is yours.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Oh, look, look. Oh.
We are the Ghetto Kids from the Pearl of Africa, Uganda.
¿Dónde está mi gente? ¿Y dónde está mi gente?
¡China!
Sí, yeah, yeah.
place for a you and I. A little space for a you and I.
Before. Look at this!
Oh! Oh yeah! Come on! Yeah! Show it to me! Yeah! Oh! Oh!
Yeah, amazing. 100% deserved.
That's never actually happened. Normally, the golden buzzer is pressed afterwards.
Oh, I got it wrong!
Yeah, someone didn't explain the rules of Britain's Got Talent to him.
He gave you the golden buzzer, and you performed with the confetti. It was magical. And by the way, who's this little one?
My name is Josephine.
Hello, Josephine. How old are you, Josephine?
5 years.
I just want to say, you're absolute superstars, every single one of you. What you're doing is absolutely incredible, and we are honoured that you have come to Britain's Got Talent. You've lit up the stage, and yes, the energy in the room and joy is incredible. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Your talent is unbelievable,
and it felt to me like you'd really raised the bar on Britain's Got Talent, so well done.
I was literally exploding, I'm telling you. You should be proud of yourself. I can't wait to see you back. That's all I can say.
I think it's incredible that you're so young, you've flown all the way, and no fear, this is an audition we're going to remember. And it was brilliant. That's what this show is all about. Yeah. And that's what the Golden Buzzer is for.
So I just
Hello.
Hello, how are you?
You look happy.
I am. I'm quite delighted. Hello.
What's your name?
My name is Daliso. Daliso Chaponda.
That's an amazing name.
That's a Malawian name.
Malawian.
Yes. So I'm from Malawi, but I live in Manchester.
Why have you come on Britain's Got Talent?
I've come to make the people laugh. I am a comedian.
Oh, and yes!
A comedy writer.
I would love the winner of Britain's Got Talent this year to be a comedian.
Oh, no pressure.
No pressure.
Who are you here with?
So I'm here just alone. My brother... No, he wanted to come. He's a doctor. And he was like, either I should save lives or come with you.
Were your parents disappointed that one of you was a comedian, one of you was a doctor?
They were absolutely horrified because I was studying computer programming. So I had a future. And I just decided, no, let me be a clown. So we shall see.
Oh, darling, good luck.
Okay, excellent. Well, I'm at that age now. All my friends are getting married, and married people forget how horrible it is being single. They love to call me and complain about their coupley problems. Always get, you are so lucky being single. I get home, my wife just starts nagging, nag, nag, nag. I'm like, hey, I have to nag myself. I get home, I'm like, what time do I call this? Why don't I ever do the dishes? Sometimes I think I don't appreciate myself. I haven't always been a comedian. I did some weird jobs. I used to clean houses, and I'll admit I was tempted to steal. I didn't steal because the Bible says, thou shalt not steal, but nowhere does it say, thou shalt not swap. I took a stereo, left a Walkman. Took a plasma screen, left an Etch-a-Sketch. as I mentioned, I am from Africa. I moved here 10 years ago. And immediately I moved here, I heard a lot of British people talking about the financial crisis, the recession. I'm from Africa. What are you maniacs talking about? You call that a crisis? If that's a crisis, where is UNICEF? Where is Bono? I have not seen one Save the UK concert. You can tell me it's a financial crisis when there are planes flying over Birmingham tossing fish and chips out the window. It will be a financial crisis when there are ads on television saying this Chav has to walk 5 miles a day to get a bottle of WKD Blue. And 100%, you have got a financial crisis when India starts opening call centers here. Can you imagine some poor guy in Mumbai calls his bank, ends up talking to a Brummie? Thank you so much, Brummie.
I mean, laugh after laugh after laugh. It just kept on coming. And I really want you to win the entire series!
Thank you.
I think you could. And I think you have a golden future.
Oh, thank you so much. I'm shocked and delighted.
So am I. Wonderful. I mean, my face is hurting from laughing. I'm so pleased that Amanda pressed a golden buzzer for you. You are brilliant, and I cannot wait to hear more from you. Well
done. Thank you so much. Thank you very much.
You should be a comedy superstar.
Yes.
All the jokes were really original and you are incredibly likable. I couldn't fault it. Well done.
Thank you very much.
Well, not only do I think you're an undiscovered little star, I could see you owning your own show.
Thank you.
What you did was so funny and naughty and unique. This is why we make shows like this, to find people like you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Thank you very much.
How about that?
That was awesome.
Just a bit.
He's so funny. Like, we were crying. So.
Yes. That's the whole UNICEF thing, I'm throwing fish and chips out the window.
Well done, fella.
Thank you so much.
Absolutely brilliant.
Thank you. My brother.
We'll see you live in the studio for the semi-finals.
Thank you so much.
Congratulations.
Off you go. Celebrate.
Thank you so much.
Woohoo! So there, have a chat with them. Good luck out there.
Good luck, pal.
Hello. What's your name, please?
My name is Musa Wakwamota. I'm originally from South Africa, but I've recently moved to London.
Oh, you did? Fantastic. Tell me about you, please.
I got diagnosed with cancer when I was young. That's led to the amputation. And I was a football player before I got amputated. And then after my amputation, I fell in love with music. My friends, they were dancing at that time. I asked them to teach me how to dance. So they threw like boxes on the floor, and then they were like, okay, this is how you do it. Your left crotch, use it as a left leg. And then that's how it started. And then I'm in London, I'm in UK, I'm in my favorite country, England. This is the perfect time for me to actually reach out to more people and inspire a lot of people out there. And yeah, that's...
Yeah. That's incredible.
So, how long have you spent preparing for this audition?
Since, I think, forever. I've been imagining myself on stage, and now it's happening, I'm like... Yeah, that's...
Yeah, I get it. I get it. Okay, well, look, no more questions.
Okay.
Good luck.
Thank you. I hope you enjoy.
Can you imagine what he's been through?
No. No.
Here.
with me.
Oh,
there's something beautiful.
That I think I've ever seen on this show. So much admiration for you, everything you've been through. You're clearly somebody, no matter what they put their mind to, you will achieve it. So well done.
That was exceptional. We all agree with that. Listen to me. We use them all. We use them all to come. Please, please. If they do it again, they kill me. But no, they're going to kill me.
Breaking the word impossible into two, I am possible. I thank you so much.
You're an absolute hero.
Tell us about Arch Junior.
Well, Arch Junior is South Africa's youngest DJ. He basically started DJing at the age of one.
He's a DJ. He's three.
That's when we discovered that he had love for music.
So he's what? He's two now.
He just turned three a month.
Just turned three.
Oh, he's three. It's understandable, eh?
All right, DJ Arch Junior. Let's see what you got. golden buzzer means one thing. It means I am loving it so much, I want to send him straight to the semi-finals.
I'm loving it!
Well done, my boy.
Amazing balancing I've ever seen.
Unbelievable.
Oh my goodness. I almost like a white kiss.
Scariest, most dangerous act I have ever seen on America's Got Talent.
There were no net.
Thank you.
I'm speechless, which is weird for me.
Good, I'll move on. Heidi.
This is how you do it!
Thank you!
I mean, you are daredevils. I'm sweating from my armpits so badly. I was screaming along. I love the two of you. You're amazing.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Sophia.
That was spectacular. It was the most exciting, fun, scary. Even the moment that you looked like you were not gonna make it, made it even better.
Unbelievable. It was from start to finish about as close to perfection I've seen over the years. You are absolutely brilliant. Thank you.
That is very scary.
Okay, we're gonna vote. Howie.
Yes.
Heidi.
A big fat yes!
Yes!
Sophia.
Yes!
I've done the numbers. It's about 4,000 yeses.
Scariest act I've ever seen.
How can you take this to another level?
We have something, a big surprise again.
You're gonna take this, it to another level?
Yes, another level.
I love you guys, man. Ramadani!
They look terrified.
Welcome.
Hi.
Hello. Are you nervous?
Yes.
Yeah, but excited to see you. Oh my God. Don't be nervous. Take a deep breath.
Howie's here.
Howie's here. Howie. What are your names?
My name is Esther.
My name is Ezekiel.
And how old are you?
I'm 17.
I'm 13.
What would winning Canada's Got Talent mean to you?
Oh my gosh.
It will be the best.
I'll be the happiest born on earth. Mom will be proud of me, and that's all I want.
Oh.
All right.
Heartstring.
You guys are adorable.
I'm Esther.
I'm Ezekiel.
And we are singers. We were born in Uganda, Kampala. My mom left Uganda when I was 11 years old. My brother was 7. And we were separated for 5 years.
Yeah, that was so sad. Being there without my mom for 5 years has been the hardest moment of my life.
I decided to leave Uganda because I came out because of my sexuality. Being a gay woman in Uganda and married to a pastor, that's an abomination.
She decided to go and make a new life for her babies.
Babies. Children.
She calls us her babies, though.
Our mom has been our music teacher, and she has really helped us throughout the phone, though we have not been with her for those past 5 years when we were gonna sing somewhere. She has helped us a lot. So all this time of our life, she has been really like our singing teacher. I used to call them over the phone and then tell them, make the song your own song. And that's what I tell them even now.
A year ago, we united with our mom. We were so happy we felt at home. My mommy's is home.
We are so happy that you're here with us. And we're excited.
I would have never done this if mom wasn't here, I swear.
When we win, Canada's Got Talent, we will buy some time off for you.
So you want me to get off work?
Yeah, get off work and relax your mind because you work too much.
I'll be so glad if I spend time with you.
We'll take you to Las Vegas.
Yes. You think so?
And Howie, I love Howie.
Howie, my girl, I know.
I love
Howie. I don't know how he's
going to miss. And he's going to be my judge. That's why I'm so scared.
Well, listen, we can't wait to see what you do. Good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you.
If I should die before I wake, it's kind of took my breath away. Losing you is like living in a world with no air.
Oh. I'm here alone, to want to leave. My heart will move, it's incomplete. But still, as a way that I'll make you understand.
But how do you expect me to live alone with just me? Cause the world revolves around your wisdom. So hard for me to breathe. Tell me I'm supposed to breathe in no air. Can't live, can't breathe in no air. It's all a few when I'm there. No air, no air.
Got me out in the water so deep. You told me I'm gone. tell me I am the one so deep. Tell me how I'm gonna breathe without me. If you ain't you, I just can't breathe. No air, no air.
Thank you.